Stefan Molyneux, freedomainradio.com, Stefan Molyneux on Twitter, YouTube Free Domain Radio as well. A lot going on. Thanks for joining us via Skype. I just threw a lot out there. What do you want to tackle first?
Oh, let's just talk about the incipient victory of reason and evidence, Alex. I am pumped. I'm thrilled. Today, it's Brexit Day. Woohoo! Breaking free of the raft that is going over the Niagara into collectivized statist nightmares. So this, I think, is the beginning of the crack-up of the EU. I know there have been some setbacks, but I think it's beautiful. The fact that the EU, this great collective mess that was foisted on Europe against the will of the citizenry, they had to have referendum after vote till they got the one that they wanted. The fact that this experiment is cracking up in a similar time frame that the Soviet Union cracked up shows that there is still reason and sanity in human affairs, and I'm very excited about what's coming up.
I agree with you. I mean, clearly, even globalists admit the tide's going out. They're in crisis. Their answer is more wars and an alliance with Islam that can't even tie its shoelaces, and they're constantly killing each other. What the hell is the left with marches everywhere putting hijabs on women? And I mean, I can't even make something up this absurd.
Well, here's the thing, right? So this collectivism that happened in Europe. Now, the Democrats have a big problem in that they lost, right? They had a very experienced candidate running against a first-time newbie, and they lost. So they have to come up with some reason that protects the elites as to why they lost. So now it's all Russia and all this kind of crap, right? It's the same thing when you had two giant world wars in Europe in the 20th century. Within the space of a couple of decades, the elites were facing rebellion within their own ranks. So they had to make up this story as to why we had all these terrible wars and 50 million people got killed and so on. And their answer was, Alex, do you know what caused these wars? Borders. Yes, it's borders. So if we get rid of borders, it's not the elite, it's not the military-industrial complex, and it sure as hell isn't central banking. Never want to touch that. It's borders. Like, in other words, if your home gets robbed, the problem is your walls. So if we take down your walls, everything's going to be fine. And so the fact that they had this argument was fallacious.
In Austin zoning, they are now under Gen 21, not allowing walls on new homes or apartments. No gates, no nothing, but the elites all live in the old part of the city and are building bigger walls. You cannot make this up. And of course, since you mentioned the fact that absolutely globalism was the answer to these wars that they admittedly stirred up to bring in the League of Nations and the UN, David Rockefeller, who just died last week, admitted in his memoirs, Reflections and other books he wrote, that his family actually helped engineer this, and they even helped fund Hitler and the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute to control the full spectrum. I mean, talk about nastiness. They don't want us to have nations so we can get together and resist their globalist operation.
Well, and people, of course, think that the EU was some spontaneous organization of the masses, like, oh, we're facing giant consolidated totalitarianism behind the Soviet bloc and so on. So what we need is another giant layer of bureaucracy and central planning, because that's how you fight communism. It's with socialism. I've never for the life of me understood that logic. That's like fighting a headache by cutting your own head off. But of course, it was the American elites who helped fund the origins of the EU. It came out of precursors to the CIA. They never funded less than half of the groups that were advocating for it. It is a globalist, centralized, CIA-based, collectivist nightmare. And finally, Europe seems to be waking up from this nightmare.
Stefan, it's dangerous to pause for me because I'll run over you. But look, what you're saying
I'm giving you room to speak, Alex. I feel it's the only simple thing to do.
What you're saying is not your opinion. I mean, you are literally stating reality. And I love how they keep saying, you know, the right wing is in its own bubble, the left wing is in its own bubble. I'm not right wing. But I didn't like Bush when he was doing it. They called me a leftist. I'm a nationalist, a common sense guy. I'm somebody that wants sovereignty. I want local government. America isn't perfect, but the Bill of Rights and Constitution is a hell of a lot better than what North Korea and you know, Venezuela have. Look what's happening. So it's not that America ever even reached 10% of its potential, but it was going in the right direction. And so I agree with you. What's happening is prima facie. It's not like we're here just making up our own narrative and we're the fake news. No, they have brought in 5 million Muslims. 80% of them are military-age men. They are running around like they own the place. The left is literally bringing them in like reinforcements. And Peter Sutherland of the EU and UN says they're trying to get rid of Europe because it has a middle class. I mean, what's weird is in their white papers, they tell the truth. And it's so crazy and so bad then in public they lie, and I'm wondering why would the elite want to blow up the West that gives them this safety net for even elites? Why would they want to bring in authoritarianism when it's the most unstable system? What the hell are they doing?
Well, people who are focused on political power are drug addicts, right? We know this from studies in monkeys, that as you rise through the hierarchy of the ranks, you get endorphins, you get all of these wonderful happy brain joy juices flooding through your system, and it becomes you become an addict. They literally are addicts. Of course, they're not playing with their own money. They're playing with our lives and the lives of our children and the security of our institutions. But it's no, you can't expect sense out of these people any more than you can say, well, that gambling addict, why on earth would he end up losing his home, losing his house, losing his wife, lying face down in a ditch with a dead hooker? I mean, that's what addicts do. They continue to escalate until they're either cured or they crash. And I think we're kind of poised between the two at the moment.
Exactly. So I see what you're saying. Globalism, crony capitalism on fire, the fake left backing globalism in trouble, the establishment right wing being voted out everywhere as well. I mean, I think Paul Ryan's probably worse than Pelosi because he's actually smart. And then I see Pelosi. We'll play the clip when we come back after break in about 10 minutes. She literally, in multiple speeches, thinks Bush is still president. Maxine Waters thinks Russia invaded Korea. Doesn't even say North or South. But you can say, oh, we're cherry picking. No, that was in one press conference. We don't even play. They give me press conferences every couple days. That's even crazier. She is literally has neurological disorders. I'm sad for her. She's clearly almost 80. She clearly, you know, has a lot of facelifts and stuff. But the point is, she's got a rotten brain. And so does Maxine Waters, and they are in command. And I mean, to me, that's what's horrifying is these people are out of their minds.
Well, there is a battle on, I would say, a big picture time, is the battle is between those who are competent and those who are incompetent, but greedy. Right, like I'm incompetent in opera singing, so I don't try and dominate the stage of the Met. I mean, that's the way it works. So incompetent people hate competition, which is why everyone's trying to shut down alternative media these days, because mainstream media is terrible, wretched, compromised, and lacks even the basic integrity that would allow a snail to stay inside its own home. And so in Europe and in other places, they're trying to gut down competition between countries. Why is there so much centralization of regulation and control of a currency and control of interest rates in Brussels? Because they don't want individual countries to cut their rates and attract more investment, because competition diminishes the power of centralized oligarchical authority. And so they love layering more and more regulations. This is why power tends to aggregate to the Fed, federal government, rather than allowing states to compete. Because California will keep spending and spending and spending, but what's happening is so many people are fleeing California, at some point they're going to run out of tax livestock. So this movement to centralize and make sure everyone's running off the same standard is just a way for incompetent bureaucrats to never face competition from slightly more competent bureaucrats in other countries.
So let me ask you this. Again, great opportunity, global awakening happening. But like you said, they're incompetent but greedy. I don't understand it. I mean, the more, quote, power I get, the more concerned I am, the more careful I am, the more I watch what I say. When I say something wrong, I apologize for it. You know, I have children. I guess I'm getting older. But as I get more, quote, power, I feel more humble and like a steward, thinking about the whole species. I don't say that goody two-shoes. It's really true. Then I watch these people that claim they care about everybody, but as you know, statistically, we're not left or right, but using that paradigm, leftist in Canadian studies, British studies, 6-7 times more likely to steal, but many more times likely to virtue signal that they're actually giving and telling everyone how to act. And then I think back to when I was like 18, my mom threw me out of the house. I just graduated high school, and we'd moved houses. And, you know, she bought some Oriental rugs that today I think are awesome looking. And I was like, I don't like these. Why aren't they that color? My mom looked at my dad. She goes, David, get him the hell out of here. And she's also mad I was bringing my girlfriends in and making, you know, they were being rude to her in the kitchen or whatever. And so she's like, you know, get him the hell out of here. She loves me, but it's time for you to be gone, buddy. So it was only at that point that I genetically needed to have my own house that I was telling my mother what to do. And I think it's the same thing. They've never built their own houses. So of course they want to micromanage everybody else's, because once you have your own family, have your own house, have your own friends, you would never get involved with somebody else because you're too busy with your own life.
Well, here's the thing, Alex. I mean, I think I can speak for both of us. Our power, as you call it, is not coercive. It's not political. We can't force anyone to do a damn thing. We can't force people to listen. We can't force people to support you.
I don't want them to. I mean, it's like wanting a woman to get in bed with you because she wants you. You don't want to rape her.
So, yeah, our authority is earned through slowly gathered credibility in the free market of ideas. And yes, we make mistakes, we have to backtrack, we're human beings, and that's natural. If we claim to never make mistakes, we wouldn't have as much credibility as the mainstream media. So your power, which is influence, is gained incrementally over the course of many years of interacting in the free market. You have a reputation, which, as you know, takes decades to build and can take 10 minutes to completely destroy. It's not the same as political power. What we have is an addiction, in a sense, to communication through truth, but we're not dependent upon any coercion for our audience. So we don't have that kind of corrupting power. We have earned influence power through hopefully being correct more than we're wrong.